My name is Robert Squinch. I am representing Harlow MMA. I'm fighting with Steven McGregor. I don't know much about him, and to be honest, I don't have any specific plan, so we'll just see how it will happen. So good luck to me and good luck to him.
Steven McGregor, fighting out at Lions Pride MMA and Sports Studios, trained by Dino Maringo. Name of the show is Unfinished Business. Tonight I got a lot of it. The dude I'm fighting, he ducked me for my last fight on the last show. Had an injury. Tonight I'm gonna make him suffer.
This is a lightweight pro mixed martial arts bout to be contested over 3 5-minute rounds. Now making his way to the octagon, fighting out of blue corner, representing Ripped MMA in Harlow. Please put your hands together for Robert Scooten. This evening, making his way to the octagon, fighting out of the red corner, representing Lions Pride and Sports Studio in London. Now please, put your hands together for Steven McGregory!
Right, so pro MMA over 3 5-minute rounds. Robert Scoogins from Ripped MMA Harlow versus Steven McGregor from Lions Pride. And so, Josh, our first pro fight of the evening. So anything goes now.
Yeah, certainly the dynamic changes a fair bit once you bring in that ground and pound to the head.
And I saw Scoogins fight recently against Jude Samuel. A very quick tap out in the first round.
Oh!
And that was a very good right roundhouse to the face of Robert Scoogins from McGregory.
Yeah, Scoogins has recovered very well though, immediately scrambling in on that single leg, using it to stand back up. Already trying to work some of the judo.
And a big knee attempt just blocked by Scoogins.
Yeah, managed to transition to a nice throw, and it was very nice how he switched the hip there to sit through into Kezagatami now, the scarf hold. Really trying to, he needs to get his hip off the ground, plant his left foot, we see him plant his left foot a bit more, start driving into his opponent, really crushing the diaphragm.
And it was a good tactic because we saw upright just how dangerous in those few short moments McGregor was.
Yeah, as soon as his hands came down, it was shin to chin straight away from McGregor.
And again, he had a good knee attempt that Scoogins just saw.
We can see here that Scoogins has made a bit of an amateur mistake. It's something we do see from a lot of judo fighters. The scarf hold going around the head. If the guy can just bump, he can work your way to the back. And we saw that's what McGregor was able to do there.
Well, for Scoogins now, it's very simple. He's got to be either well away or close enough to get that for that shoot for him, because McGrory showed how dangerous he was. But good left hand there from Skujins.
He's really winging his punches. Oh, lovely trip though. Just countering the kick and taking the fight to the canvas. He's earned himself close guard here.
Yes, good work there from Skujins against a dangerous opponent, and his own left hand wasn't too bad either. So again, Skujins twice has negated his man, but allowed him to get up.
Yeah, surprising there from Skujins. He was certainly pushing on the face, trying to break the closed guard open. Oh!
And he's paid for it, Josh, in the most dynamic way, a spinning back fist. I did not see the logic of allowing his man up, and this is the result.
Yeah, no, I think you're absolutely right, Malcolm. Surprising he let the fight get back to his feet, and he really is in a bit of trouble here. The elbow's coming in now.
Yes, vicious elbow strikes right above our commentary position.
Yeah, if McGorry can keep this work rate up, Skujins is going to have to do something to recover here.
Well, he's got to intelligently defend himself from those elbows, and I think that's what Mark Woodard's telling him. No, I didn't think so, Josh. You could see Mark Woodard saying it's got to be intelligent defence. Yep. It came from letting him up, then that spinning back fist.
Yeah, just a poor decision in the heat of the moment, I think, from Skujins. That's a spinning back fist really doing the damage there, and relentless ground and pound from McGrory.
And we have a winner at 2 minutes 45 seconds in the very first round by way of ref stoppage. Fighting out of the red corner, Stephen McGrory! And a big round of applause for a very game fighter in Robert Skujins.
I'm with Steve McGrory. He's just walked out of the cage victorious after what I can only describe as highlight reel knockout. Man, just talk me through that. You dropped him twice in this fight, one by head kick and then second by spinning back fist.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Were they planned? What was going through your mind?
Yeah, totally planned. I was just timing it and he was a sucker for it. I just caught him clean.
Hands down and all that stuff.
What can I say? Just dropped to the floor like a sack of potatoes. So.
And so this was your first pro fight, wasn't it?
Second pro fight. It was my second pro MMA fight.
Right, so second pro, but to be honest, you were quite brutal with the elbows, you were brutal with the ground and pound, and you showed no mercy. Is that like a whole new part of your game?
Yeah, it's definitely been in the making a few years now, but it's always been my forte, just bang the hands in, bang the elbows, bang the knees in, bang the big head kicks in.
Well, unbelievable. I'm sure Fusion Fighting Championships will be using that knockdown as part of the highlights for this show, so it's amazing. What's up for you next?
Just more fights for Fusion, more fights.
Excellent, I'll be looking forward to seeing you fight soon.
Thanks a lot. Cheers.
Thank you, mate, cheers.
My name's Dean Hawkins, and I like to bang and ball. My last one went really well. Not the geezer out in 29 seconds. Now it's time to take the bacon home, and this is what it's all about.
Hello, my name is Tade Sinushkis. I'm fighting for Antonio Jim. I'm gonna fight against Dean Hawkins, and thumbs up, everything's gonna go really well.
This is a welterweight title fight held under semi-pro mixed martial arts rules and to be contested over 2 4-minute rounds. Now, making his way to the octagon, fighting out of the blue corner, representing Antonio's Gym in London, please put your hands together for Tadas Janjuskas! opponent making his way to the octagon, fighting out of the red corner, representing Extreme Gym and Nova Forza. Please put your hands together for Dean Hawkins! Ladies and gentlemen, this is a welterweight title bout to be contested under 2 4-minute rounds under the semi-pro mixed martial arts rules.
So this is the Fusion semi-pro MMA title fight at welterweight over 2 4-minute rounds. Tadas Yonuskis from Antonio's Gym versus Dean Hawkins from the Extreme Gym and Nova Forza. And huge support here, Josh, for Dean Hawkins.
Yeah, as we'd expect from the guys at Nova Force, are always bringing a huge crowd to these events.
And I've seen Tadas fight before. He's a very competent young man, pretty good upright.
Yeah, throwing in those low kicks, but he's eating a few shots here and getting a bit overzealous with the knees. Yanukis.
Yes, another knee from Hawkins there. And Yanukis, this is going to be over very, very quickly with that big knee to the side of the body as well.
Wow, he did such aggressive damage on the feet that as soon as his opponent started to go down, that huge knee to the side, just the icing on the cake for him there.
Well, Josh, when you think how short this fight is and the damage that has already been done to Yanukis with the crew looking at him, it was a vicious, vicious start, and Yanukis is no mug, but it was so accurate from Hawkins with those knees.
Yeah, Hawkins just really overwhelming his opponent straight off the bat. A lot can be said at lower levels in MMA for just sheer outright aggression, really taking the fight to the opponent can throw them off, and I think that's exactly what we saw tonight. Yanukis not really given any opportunity to do anything but cover and defend.
No, and the finisher was not to the face. It was that vicious knee to the ribcage.
Ladies and gentlemen, while Tadas is being attended to by the ref and medical staff, we'll go ahead and announce the winner in a astonishing 31 seconds in your very first round. Winner by ref stoppage and new welterweight title champion. Put your hands together for Dean Hawkins!
Hi, I'm here with Dean Hawkins. Dean, the last fight was over in 28 seconds. This time you charged in as well. Was that the game plan?
Well, yeah, just sort of if I see a shot, I'll try and take it and then try and exploit it. And then whatever areas he lets me see, I'll try and take him out there. Knees, punches, body shots, whichever it takes. Really pleased with how it worked. Everything I've been working hard, Dan Nova Forza, on my jiu-jitsu, you know what I mean? Working hard, knees with my cover coach, Danny Savage, and just everything sort of come together today. So just good old-fashioned hard work and good coaches, good teachers, and good other lads in the gym that have been helping me out. So it's more credit as well to my gyms and to my coaches, really.
All right, it was brilliant. We look forward to another explosive fight from you.
Hopefully you see me very soon in November, definitely. Cheers, thanks.